So I'm going to be talking about a technique called Bayesian optimization. It's sometimes called AI to improve AI. And one of the reasons this is super important is that we've seen recently an explosion in machine learning. And one of the things that's so exciting is that the things that were science fiction in, say, the early 80s, when you see the vision recognition in the Terminator series, for instance, is now becoming science fact. And with that has become an explosion in the number of people that want to use it. The problem is that these models are incredibly flexible and have a huge number of parameters that you might want to tune. And getting these wrong can have disastrous effects, especially when you're starting to move machine learning into areas of decision making. So what I do is I use a second type of machine learning to automatically learn how to build these models so that they are maximally efficient and build them in a small amount of time and cost as possible. Now, a good analogy I like to use is to think of this as a really, really hard search problem. So imagine some children playing hide and seek in a house. Right? They don't just go randomly all over the place. They don't go in a systematic manner, you know, from room to room in like a grid. What they do is they have an idea, an opinion. They then use that opinion to make a decision. And from that decision, they choose where to make an observation. And Bayesian optimization works in precisely the same manner. You use a mathematical model, a Bayesian model, which will give you a prediction and an uncertainty. And in the presence of this uncertainty, in this prediction, you form an opinion about which point will give you the most value to go and explore. You go and explore that point, and once you've explored it, you use it to update your model. So your model gets increasingly more efficient and more accurate about predicting where the best places are to go. The other thing that we do in Bayesian optimization, again, think of the children in the house, is there's some constraints. You may say that I know that the attic is off limits, so I'm not going to go and search there. You can formulate the same kind of thing for these models. You can also say, well, actually, I'm not going to search down the bottom of the garden first because it's going to take me a long time to get there. So you can take into account the cost of acquiring a data point as well as the potential that it is giving you what you want to see.